The exhibition's title is Unfamiliar Again, which I think is a fantastic title because I think for any artist, but abstract painters in particular, the idea of, you know, how do we make abstract paintings that are viable and meaningful in the time that we live in? For decades and decades, 100 years, people have been saying, painting is dead, abstraction is dead, and I think the idea of making it unfamiliar again is really essential, and it's really exciting, and I'm glad that that's the title of the show. I have this kind of basic vocabulary of very simple geometric forms that then I bring into Illustrator and Photoshop and kind of push and pull and chop them up into bits and spin them around. And I create these, basically these layers that I'm kind of using and reusing from one document to the next as I'm designing the work. And once that design is finished, I spend many, many, many months actually turning that into a physical object. And again, this kind of manifestation of a virtual thing into a physical, real thing that has a physical material presence is really important to me. And the painting is actually symmetrical. It's a diptych, and you can kind of, if you look at it, you can see that they're absolutely identical mirror images of each other, except for one element. There's one layer in the painting, and it's this kind of background gradient that is flipped. And it's kind of meant to create this kind of circular motion through the painting and the way that your eyes move through the painting. The sculptural installation is essentially almost like as if you looked at the painting and took out all of those little pieces and gave them three-dimensional forms. The sculptural installation is cast in caustic, and my paintings are oil and encaustic paint. Caustic is a beeswax medium, and it's beeswax and damar and dry pigment that's mixed in. And so the sculptural piece is actually made the same way. It's cast in caustic form, so they're solid. And it's interesting, they, I think, have a real optical presence. They are loaded with pigment, so they behave in kind of a funny way, very different than, let's say, if they were cast plaster and painted or something like that. You know, if we think of abstract painting as a continuum and we think of it as something that is hopefully advancing and kind of moving forward, maybe technology is the thing that can help us do that, can help us take abstract painting to a place where it's never really been before.